بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Okay, what we're going to do now is unzip Shamila and make it ready to use. So the first thing we need to do is find the zipped Shamila folder, which is probably on a DVD if that's what we received it on, or it's probably in our downloads folder if we downloaded it from the internet. In any case, my one is in the D drive, so I'm going to go there. D drive work, and here we go, Shamila library. It's going to look something like that. Okay, now what we need to do is we need to unzip it. Okay, if you haven't saved it anywhere already, probably the best thing to do is first copy it onto the desktop from your folder. You want to copy it onto the desktop. So if you hold the right click, the right mouse button on it, and then you drag it using the right button, not the left button, remember, and do that and copy it to desktop. So you copy it here. That will take some time depending on how fast your machine is. We'll just wait for that to load. We can get rid of that. I'm just going to pause the recording while this finishes. Now it will carry on the recording. So you can see that the Maktaba Shamila library, the zipped version, is here on the desktop. Now this icon is a WinRAR icon. That means it's still zipped, it's not usable. Okay, if we double click on it, it won't open Maktaba Shamila, it'll open something like this. Okay, so what do we need to do? What we need to do is we need to find this. You know, I put it on the desktop, but you can put it in whichever folder you want to eventually store your Shamila in. We right click on that. If we do have WinRAR installed, which you must have, we'll have these three options here. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to extract here. Right, now this is now opening this. This is 2 gigabytes, and this will eventually be close to 10 gigabytes. Okay, how long this process will take depends on how fast our machine is. As you can see, my computer's saying that it's going to take 2 hours, 3 hours. It'll probably take longer, but I've done already had this done, so I'm going to pause the recording. So you have to let that finish. That will take a long time. The green bar will slowly grow and cover this whole place, inshallah. Okay, so now once that whole folder has unzipped or extracted and it is in here, which eventually will be something like 10 gigabytes, when we double click on it, we will get something like this. So this is Al Maktaba Shamila basically, and by double clicking on this, the program will open. Let's double click on that, shamila.exe, and inshallah, for the first time it'll ask you, do you want to run it? Then you have to press yes. Taking its time, but it will open inshallah. Okay, so there we go, Al Maktaba Shamila. Right, it always asks, هناك تحديث برقم 3.474, هل تريد تحميله الآن? That there's an update. Okay, personally, I don't like using the updates because in my experience, it's often made Shamila crash and made it stop working, so I just don't bother updating. I do it every once in a while manually. Okay, so this is the Maktaba Shamila interface. Quite simply, here we have Ikhtiyar Kitab. We have the list of books categorized by the sciences, Al-Aqidah, Al-Tafasir, Ulum Al-Quran. We can click on any one of them, double click, and that will give us that book. Here we have the search, the best facility in my view. Here we can search for books, search for things inside books. So for example, if we're looking for a particular hadith, we can go to Mutun al-Hadith. What these two buttons, Al-Majmu'atu Kulluha, that will select all the books in that category. Ilgha'u al-Majmu'a, it will deselect all of them. And on the left hand side, we have Jami'u Kutub al-Barnamaj. So when we click on that, it will select all the books in the program, all the thousands and thousands and thousands of books. They'll all be selected. So that might be useful if you're looking for something and you really badly need it, but you have no idea what type of book that particular text, that particular quote might be found in. So you can look in Jami'u Kutubul Barnamij. Naturally, that will take a long time to search, even if you have a very fast computer. Now, the other important thing to bear in mind is that the Arabic phonetic keyboard will not instantly work in Al-Maktabatu Shamila. By default, every time you open Al-Maktabatu Shamila and you click inside a box, it will change the keyboard to Arabic 101 or 102. Even if you only have phonetic installed, it will do that itself, right? So if, for example, if you're on obviously I think they've installed that, they've made that do that, so if you're using English before, then it will automatically change to Arabic. But if you're used to Arabic phonetic, then that's a bit of a headache. So what you will have to do is either every time you click in a box, an example, you want to try to write Assalam, when you press A, Sheen will come up because it's using the other Arabic keyboard. So either you'll have to select the Arabic phonetic and write Assalam. Okay, but again, like I said, the moment you click in a new box, it will change the keyboard back again. Again, I'm pressing A and Sheen comes up. So if you want to put something in the next box, you have to go back and change Arabic phonetic. This will happen every time you click out of a box. So that's one way of doing it, is to keep changing the keyboard every time you want to type a word. The other way is to use the on-screen keyboard, which is what I personally prefer if you're just searching for simple words or one or two words. So if you use this, then it saves you having to change all the time. You can just use this, because that will obviously not change. That is the standard Arabic keyboard. You can just type using that for right. Okay, leave that there, and you know, you can play around with and get used to using the Shamila interface. And yeah, that's how you Shamila. You press that, it'll begin searching. Right, we'll cancel that for the time being. The last thing I do want to show you though is that to make your life easier, you probably want to send a shortcut for this onto the desktop. So the easy way of doing that is right click, send to desktop, and create shortcut. So what you'll have is you'll have a shortcut for Maktabatu Shamila here, which you can click and it will automatically launch Al-Maktabatu Shamila. Although there is a setup icon which you'll find inside Maktabatu, you don't need to install Maktabatu Shamila. You can just use it straight from the folder. You can put it on a USB stick, you can put it on a hard disk, and you can use it anywhere. You don't need to install the program. As far as I understand, I think that's everything we need to know about Al-Maktabatu Shamila. So please drop me a line if you have any problems. Jazakumullah khairan.